السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this video, I'm going to tell you how to create the cash flow and cost loading from your BOQ using the Excel Power Query. Maybe you didn't hear about the Excel Power Query and you think it is something complicated. But in this video, I'm going to tell you how simple it is, and we are going to create the cost loading from our POQ and the activity list in very simple steps. So what I have here, this is my POQ, okay? And I copied it like this to be database friendly. So I have here POQ reference number. If this is not exist in your BOQ, you can create it, no problem. I have here the division number. If it is not also included in your BOQ, you can create it easily. We have here a scope of work, which is a BOQ item, unit, quantity, rate, the amount, and I added here one main title, and this is my BOQ. Okay, your BOQ might be a little bit different, it doesn't matter. What is really matter here is the way or the methodology I'm going to explain to you how to create your cost loading. So I start creating here the activity list. If you can see here, I have master activity ID and master activity name. So I'm going one by one in the BOQ item. Whenever I find BOQ item, I put for it here in my master activity ID. I have master activity ID here and activity name. So whenever here I go through one line, I put here the master activity ID, the relevant activity for the relevant BOQ item. So I filled all the BOQ with the relevant items, and I am now finished all of this. It might take some time from you, but once you created with this method, you are going to save a lot of working hours later on. So here, this is my BOQ. I linked it, or I created activity list from the BOQ. Okay, the second sheet here I have same as the previous one, but in that case, I have a high-rise building, and this building has some floors, so I would like to put a percentage for each floor. So I put here my floors. These are my floors, and I put a percentage for every BOQ item. What is the percentage in the relevant floor? Okay. Now I made here one check to be sure that everything is 100% at the end, and that's it. Now I'm ready to create my cost loading in a very smart way, and also I'm going to create the activity ID. Let me tell you how to do it. First of all, we will go to data, get data from other source, from table and range. This will open the Power Query for us, and please don't be scared, it is very simple. So this is my table, okay? And I can do very nice things now. For example, I don't need the 100% column at the end, so I'm going to make right click and remove. This will not actually remove it from my data source. It will only remove it from this Power Query. Now I need to change all the floor numbers into percentage. So I can make shift and select here, sorry, from the first, make shift to the end, then from home here, data type, I will make it percentage. So I converted all the numbers here to percentage. Now I will make something called unpivot. Unpivot will make for me the required step to make my cost loading. So I'm going right click and click unpivot columns. Now I have here each BOQ item, and I have the floor and the floor percentage. Now I can change this one into floor. Okay, and now I have this very nice table. I can now store this table in a table here in Excel, or I can keep it as a query only. In that case, I'm going to make close and load to, and I'll make create connection only. This will store the steps I have created in this Power Query, okay? Now, I'm going to my activity list. I will do the same from data, get data, from other sources, from table or range. And I don't need to do anything here. This is the activity list. I don't need to do anything. Just I'm going to make close and load to. And I'll make only create connection. Now I have these two tables, okay, in my query. So simply I can now right click here and click merge. So I'm going to merge these two tables. I'm going to merge the activity list with the BOQ. Then I'll click here, the BOQ reference here, the BOQ reference here. So it will be one table connecting these two queries. Then I'm going to click OK. This is my first table, okay, my first query, unit quantity, blah, 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 and this is the, here, the most important thing, the master activity ID. Okay, now I'm going to expand the second table. What I need from here, I have the BOQ reference already, so I don't need it. I have BOQ number, I have BOQ item, I have all of this. All I need is the let me remove this column. All I need is the floor and the value. Okay. So now I can create one column to multiply the floor percentage by the amount of the BOQ so I can get the activity amount. How we can add it? Very simple. I can make here column. I will call it activity amount. It will be equal to the amount of the BOQ. I will multiply by the floor percentage. Then I will click OK, and I have here the activity amount. Now I have a master activity ID, and I need to merge it or add to it the floor so I can create activity ID, a unique activity for each floor. So in that case, I can make here in the BOQ floor, right click, replace value, and I'll change all the old floors. Let's make it AL. I'll click OK. Now foundation, right click, replace value. I'll make it FO. I'm trying to reduce the number of characters, so when I add it to the master activity ID, it will not be too much. Now the water tank, I make replace value, make it WT. This one, I'll make replace value L4. This one, replace value L3. See how powerful is the Power Query? It will help you a lot. This will make L2. I'll tell you the purpose of this one in a second. Just bear with me. So this one L1. Ground level. Make it GL. Replace value mezzanine. Ground M. We have too many floors here. We can do it in Excel or we can do it here in the Power Query. It doesn't matter. But I'm just trying to tell you how powerful it is. This one, let's make it M4. I'm just giving a code, a short code for each level here. Okay. So this one will be 05. This one will be 06. this one will be 07. I'm going to speed the video so we'll not get bored. Now I have a short code for each floor. So what's the purpose of this one, Yahani? We have here a master activity ID. This master activity ID is repeated in all floors, or maybe in one floor, two floors, three floors. So I need to create a unique activity ID for each activity. So I'm going here to add a column. I'll call this one activity ID. And in that case, I'm going to add here the master activity ID, and I'll make and double quota dash and the BOQ floor, I just make it short. Now I have here a very nice activity ID, which is telling me the master activity ID and the floor. And that's it. Now I'm ready to create my cost loading. In that case, I'm going to file, close and load to, and I'm going to make it in a new worksheet so I can see the data. I'll click OK. And this is my nice table. Now I need to do one check. I have here, this is my BOQ, the amount of the BOQ. Let's make it as a number so we can read it easily. We have here 106,996,379. Now I need to check that the activity amount is the same. Make format cells and make it number 106,996,378, which is okay. This is one dollar or dirham or Saudi riyal only. No, not a big deal because of fraction. So now I'm ready to create my cost loading. But Hani, how I can create now my cost loading? Because one activity here might be repeated several times, and I need to gather all the activities. This is very simple. We will create now insert pivot table, okay, from table and range. We'll make it a new sheet. Now simply I'll put the activity ID and the activity amount, and that's it. Congratulations, you now have a very detailed cost loading, okay, and you can import this one to your Primavera. You can update the budget cost, and also there are ways to create the WBS and the resource loading using the same ways. If you are interested to know more about the, how to import things to Primavera and so on, I have created a special course for this one at a very discounted price in Udemy. You will find the link below. You are welcome to go and check it. I hope you find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.